Yeah, so the phrase "Life is messy and God is mysterious," which is the subtitle, part of the subtitle of my new book, The Grand Paradox, what does that really mean? And it's something that I got from a pastor friend of mine who had developed it really off of Eugene Peterson's writings. But it's this idea that life is messy, but we always somehow feel like it shouldn't be, and we're just one step away or 1 month away or one big paycheck away from being able to clean it up. You know, we can just get to that season where it's all going to be a little bit easier. And we chase that thing. The grass is always greener on the other side of the hill. And what we sometimes have to do is just accept the fact that life is messy and let it be what it really is and not always try and think that somehow it's supposed to be or going to be cleaner. And then corresponding to that, that God is mysterious, but we don't think he should be. We think God should answer all our questions. We think God should be a little bit easier to find. We think God should be neater and cleaner and more on our level. And so we're always trying to pray or ask for things in prayer, or we're always reaching or grabbing to try and understand or comprehend a little bit more of what God is thinking or why he's doing what he's doing, so that we can then finally take a deep breath and go, the tension is now out of this. It's not as frustrating, or I'm not as lost or confused. And the reality is God is mysterious. He just is. And he's never going to be as easy to put in a box, or it's never going to be as easy to understand maybe what he's doing in our life as we would want it to be. And so we just posit the fact that God is mysterious and that that's okay. And so as a starting point, we start with life being messy and that God is mysterious, but somehow in the middle of this, we learn to live by faith that despite the messy circumstances and despite some of this confusion, that we are called to this life of faith, and that as we walk forward, we will find that God is faithful, and he will provide just enough information at just enough of or at certain times along the journey for us to sustain, or he'll bring times of refreshing. Even if the circumstances don't change, he'll spiritually refresh us just enough along the walk or along the path that we can sustain. And so we find that in the midst of the mess and the mystery, that we have this necessity of faith, and that joy and true life and all that is good is going to come not by fighting this, but in walking by trust that God really has promised that this is the way we're supposed to go, and that if we go this way, it's the best way that we possibly can go. And so we continue on in faith, knowing that Jesus came to bring us life, and not just life, but life to the full, fullness of life, fullness of joy. He says in John 15, I tell you these things to obey God, to be found with God in God's love, so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. And so this difficult walk where our eyes kind of don't see all of the rational reasons to go forward, but we go forward anyway by trust, that is where we're going to find fullness of joy, the best life that we could possibly have. Even though it might be messy, God's still going to remain mysterious. So that's a little bit of what I mean, and that's kind of the starting point for all of my teaching or preaching as a pastor, that people coming in on any given Sunday, they're coming in and life is messy, God is mysterious, and somehow the conversation we're having needs to be about what faith looks like between those two poles. It's a great question, so thank you. Thank you for asking that.